Hello children, in English grammar, subject-verb agreement is one of the topic which you all study. In this, you have to understand what is this agreement about. So this agreement is between the subject and the verb. That is, certain rules have been decided based on which the subject will come along with the verb. So many of you must be already aware of with the subjects like he or she, it is always does that comes. It is not do, okay? And like when we have to say he goes or he go. So what we will say, he goes or he go? We will say it is he go, he or she goes. But at the same time, if the subject is plural, that is they, so with they, it will come go. Okay, or we'll say they do not or they do so, but with he and she it will be does. So this is something basic, you must be already aware of these things. Now another important thing that which you should know is that whenever you see a subject, you have to first see whether it is countable or it is uncountable. If it is countable, it can be in singular form or it can be in plural form. But in case if it is uncountable, or see in case of here, or we say there are many material or abstract noun which we take it as uncountable and it is always singular. Like we always say my hair is black, we will not say they are black. Okay, it is always taken as singular. So just like here, there are many other uncountable nouns or uncountable subjects with which we will always use singular verb. Okay, so like in the first question we see my hair is black. If I say poetry is good, poetry is also singular. Okay, scenery, advice, luggage, furniture, information, these all are uncountable, hence we take them as singular. With them is will come and it will not be are. Okay, so with uncountable subjects, what we use, uncountable subjects are always singular. Like here is singular, but yes, we can say two hairs on your shoulder. So when we say two hairs, so there it will become hairs when we are saying two hairs. So it depends upon context also. But when we say just here, my hair, okay, so it will be only H-A-I-R here, and with that singular verb, that is will come. Okay. Now let us look at the second example in this question. My goggles, what will come here, is or are? So here again you have to see that whenever you see anything or any subject which is found in pair, means it is in the form of V for victory. Okay, so when we say it is in the pair, like goggles, you see it is in pair, you see two glasses are there for both your eyes. So whenever you find anything which is in pair, then it is always plural. I can give you a few more examples like scissors, pants, trousers, socks, slippers, goggles, jeans, they all are always used in pairs. And if one part is destroyed or is not in use, the other part also becomes unusable. We cannot use that, right? So whenever the things that are or the subject is found in pairs, then it is always taken as plural. So here what our answer will be, my goggles, goggles is in plural. So with that, the verb will also be plural. So answer will be R. Okay, here our answer was yes. Now let's say we use the word, if our subject is hands or legs or eyes, they are in pairs, but it's not like we will not follow the same rule over here. Okay, because if one hand is not in use, another hand can be in use. Okay, so we don't consider them in this particular rule. But yes, scissors, pants, trousers, they are always in pair and they can be used when they are in pair. so they are always taken in plural. Whereas hands, legs, eye, we can use them in singular also. Okay. Now coming to the next question, my scissors. Yes, scissors also we see them in pairs. So what it will be? It will be plural form of verb. So here again, R will be our answer. Now in the next question, the question is the dash were grazing in the field. What we will use, cattle or cattles? Yes. So before I tell you the answer for this, I want to tell you that there are few subjects, a few words which appear to be, you know, like plural, means they are singular, they appear to be singular, but they are actually plural. Okay. I want to repeat my statement again that they appear to be singular, but they are actually plural. So it includes cattle. Okay, we will never use the word cattles. Cattles is a wrong word. There is no such word. We use the word cattle. Vermin. Okay, vermin. Gentry or people. Peasantry. Children. Children. We will never use the word children's. It is always children. Or police. Police, sometimes depending upon the context, it can change. So these words, they appear to be singular, but they are actually plural. So here, what our answer will be? The cattle. Okay, cattle were grazing in the field. Okay, now coming to the next question, vermin. So vermin also, as I said, it will be, it appear to be singular, but it is plural. So our answer will be, yes, it is going to be half. Okay, the vermin have destroyed the crops. Next question, the police has or have caught the robber? See, in maximum case, whenever we use the word police, it is plural. Okay, the police have. So here our answer will be the police have caught the robber. Next question, 20 dash were grazing in the field. So what it will be? Will it be sheep or sheeps? Yes, our answer will be, yes, it will be sheep. Okay, here 20 sheep. So 20 sheep, why we are using 20 sheep? See, sheep, there is no such word called sheeps. Okay, this is a wrong word. So they are also like, they are plural. They appear, this word sheep appear to be as only one single sheep. So we can say one sheep, but yes, with 20 also, we will not write it as sheeps. It will be sheep. This is our correct answer. Okay, 20 sheep, 30 sheep. Whatever it is, the word, the correct word is sheep only. They appear to be singular, but they are plural. But yes, they can be used as singular also. Okay. Now, the dash cannot live without water. What? It is it fish or fishes? We'll use the word fish. Okay. The fish cannot live without water. Yes, there is a word called fishes also. We use it, but it means variety of fishes. Okay. Whenever we have to use like he cooks variety of fishes, or he cooks fishes, means he is cooking variety of fishes. So there the term fishes will come, otherwise it is fish. Fish appears to be singular, but yes, it is plural, and depending upon what we want to tell, we can use the word. Next one is he killed two. Yes, what will come here? He killed two deers or deer? It will be deer. Okay, there is no such word called deers. We will not be using deers. So it will be, answer will be here in the last one also, answer is deer. Okay, so two deer is the correct answer, or one deer. This term is wrong. There will not be two deers. So I hope this is clear to you all. I will tell few more things about subject verb agreement with few more set of questions. Thank you.